to analyze people with dark psychology. Behavioral psychology techniques for recognizing personalities. Deciphering micro-expressions and reading people like an open book. Written by Alfred Borden. Narrated by Tom Sandler and Eleanor Webb.
Chapter 1. Reading People Skills. We all know that reading people is a skill many of us have, maybe even you. Have you ever met someone new and gotten a distinct feeling from them? Either something didn't seem right, or you got a really good vibe from the person. That awareness is partially due to your intuition, but it also comes from your skill at reading people. Having the ability to know how to read people's body language not only saves you from potential danger, but it also gives you clues about whether or not you want to spend time with someone. When you know how to read people like a book, you have the ability to know if this person may turn out to be your new best friend. Reading someone is a talent you can develop. So let's go over how to read people's eyes and faces and understand other nonverbal cues that can indicate what type of person they really are. Knowing how to read people may take some practice, but if you follow the steps below, you'll be a master in no time. But first, let's explore why you should develop this valuable skill. Why reading people is a good skill. In any relationship, it's important to know someone thoroughly before you trust him or her. Unfortunately, that doesn't always happen. Some of us trust first, only to get hurt or disappointed later. But if you develop the skill of reading people, you can avoid this disappointment, or at least notice potential red flags with the new person. When was the last time you thought someone was friendly and nice, only to discover they were dishonest or had questionable character, such as lying, cheating, or stealing from others? People aren't always how they appear on the surface. That's why it's so important to understand how to read body language, learn how to read people's faces, and watch out for other nonverbal cues. Did you know that only a small percent of human communication is verbal? Most of our communication involves body language and expressions. For your own self-awareness and self-protection, it's essential you know how to read people by paying more attention to these nonverbal signals. The ability to read people is by far one of your most valuable skills in business. The people you interact with each day send you signals, and if you learn what to look and listen for, each person will tell you exactly how to effectively work with him. Everyone experiences the same basic human needs: results, recognition, regimentation, and relationships, with some holding more dominance than others. Depending on the weight placed on each need, people differ in personality. So what is there to read? Dozens of signals, verbal, vocal, and visuals, tell you when to speed up or slow down, when to focus on the details or when to work on building the relationship. But because people are different, the same technique won't always work. Human behavior has two dimensions. When people act and react with verbal, vocal, and visual actions in social situations, they exhibit clues to their behavioral style. Identifying that is possible by classifying a person's behavior on two dimensions: openness and directness. Open versus guarded. Openness is the readiness and willingness with which a person outwardly shows emotions or feelings and develops interpersonal relationships. Others commonly describe open people as being relaxed, warm, responsive, informal, and personable. They tend to be relationship-oriented, and in conversations with others, they share personal feelings and tell stories and anecdotes. They tend to be flexible about time and base their decisions more on intuition and opinion than on hard facts and data. They also are more likely to behave dramatically and to give you immediate nonverbal feedback in conversation. Guarded individuals, on the other hand, commonly are seen as formal and proper. They tend to be more aloof in their interpersonal relationships. They are more likely to follow the letter of the law and try to base their decisions on cold hard facts. Guarded people are usually very task-oriented and disciplined about time. As opposed to open people, they hide their personal feelings in the presence of others. Direct versus indirect. Now consider the second dimension, directness. This refers to the amount of control and forcefulness that a person attempts to exercise over situations or other people. Direct people tend to come on strong, take the social initiative, and create a powerful first impression. They are fast-paced people, making swift decisions and taking risks. They easily become impatient with others who cannot keep up with their fast pace. They are active people who do a lot of talking and appear confident and dominant. Direct people express their opinions readily and make emphatic statements. On the opposite end of that spectrum, indirect people give the impression of being quiet and reserved. They seem to be supportive and easygoing, and they tend to be security conscious, moving slowly, meditating on their decisions, and avoiding risks. They ask questions and listen more than they talk. They reserve their opinions and make tentative statements when they must take a stand. When directness is combined with openness, it forms three different recognizable and habitual behavioral styles: the socializer, the director, and the thinker. Socializer, open and direct. The socializer exhibits such characteristics as animation, intuitiveness, and liveliness. He is an idea person, a dreamer, but can be viewed as manipulative, impetuous, and excitable when displaying behavior inappropriate to a particular situation. The socializer is a fast-paced person with spontaneous actions and decisions. He is not concerned about facts and details, and tries to avoid them as much as possible. This may prompt him at times to exaggerate and generalize facts and figures. He thrives on involvement with people, and usually works quickly and enthusiastically with others. The socializer always seems to be chasing dreams, but he has the uncanny ability to catch others up in his dreams because of his good persuasive skills. He always seems to be seeking approval and pats on the back for his accomplishments and achievements. The socializer is a very creative person who has that dynamic ability to think quickly on his feet. Director, direct and guarded. The director exhibits firmness in his relationships with others, and he is oriented towards productivity and goals and is concerned with bottom-line results. Closely allied to these positive traits, however, are the negative ones of stubbornness, impatience, toughness, and even domineeringness. A director tends to take control of other people and situations and is decisive in both his actions and decisions. He likes to move at an extremely fast pace and is very impatient with delays. When other people can't keep up with his speed, he views them as incompetent. The director's motto is, "I want it done right and I want it done now." The director is typically a high achiever who exhibits very good administrative skills. He likes to do many things at the same time. He keeps adding on until the pressure builds to such a point that he turns his back and lets everything drop. Then he turns right around and starts the whole process over again. Thinker, indirect and guarded. The thinker is a persistent, systematic problem solver, but he can also be seen as aloof, picky, and critical. A thinker is very security conscious and has a strong need to be right. This leads him to have an over-reliance on data collection. In his quest for data, he tends to ask many questions about specific details. The thinker works slowly and precisely by himself, and prefers an intellectual work environment that is organized and structured. He tends to be skeptical and likes to see things in writing. Although he is a great problem solver, the thinker is a poor decision maker. He may keep collecting data even beyond the time when a decision is due. Chapter 2. Myths about body language. As any successful veterinarian would attest, when you're examining pets and consulting with their owners, making the proper diagnosis takes precedence. And with your staff...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.